In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let somebody, just one person, read for me Revelation 9, verse 6.
All power belongs to you.
Read with the Bible for me, please. Read with the Bible. Take the Bible from someone and read with the Bible. Amen. Take the microphone. Take the Bible from somebody. Take the Bible. Don't read with the phone. Amen. Hey, hey, take this one.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Revelation 9, verse 6. And in those days shall men seek death.
In those days shall men seek death.
And shall not find it.
And they will not find death.
And shall desire to die.
They will desire to die.
And death shall flee from them.
Death shall flee from them. In those days, men shall desire death. They shall not find death. They will want to die. Time is coming when people will say, I feel like, let me go come and die so that I can have rest. Because the trouble of this earth is too much. But the more you find death, the more you will not sell death. We are transiting to that time now. So everybody should get ready for this kind of season. So if you have not known Christ, you are in this place. I pity you. You don't know Jesus. You are not saved. You don't know Jesus. I pity you. I pity you. Because the Bible says, in the last days, many will be led astray. Many will be led astray. Many will be led astray. The Lord opened my eyes and showed me a ministry so plenty and so many. And God said, all the people who are following such ministry, such man of God, all of them will end up in hellfire. They are going nowhere. See, all of them. I say, how? He said, anybody Satan lead, he's going nowhere. I was giving an interesting story about a man of God who people are running after everywhere. Some of you who are miracle seeker, who does not go to church or to the mountain to seek the face of God, but to look for miracle, people were running after him. I'm not going to mention his name because many of you may know the person I'm talking about. This was his confection, the confection of a man of God. Only he kidnapped a lady in his church and he took her to a far place. Where he kidnapped a lady is, he built a very beautiful house inside a forest. And that is where the lady is. So people were looking for the lady. Say the lady has been kidnapped. So they forgot about her. The lady, they did a burial for the lady. This thing happened, let me not mention, but within our environment. Did burial for the lady, and the lady was forgotten. The family was paid off. Nobody knew that this was the same their papa that kidnapped the lady. A lady got missed in the church, that one. And what he was doing, every season he will go to the lady, we impregnate the lady. After 7 months, he will remove the baby. They will bring a daughter. They will force the baby out of the lady. And they will cook the lady, they will cook the baby. The man of God will eat it. This was a source of his power. So when he comes to the altar, he will just say, receive. And people were running after him. able, maybe if I mention his name now, some of you here, you will be there. Who belong to some brotherhood in this country. White power. So if you don't know God, some of you here will be led astray. That's why you have to have an encounter with Jesus, personal encounter with him. So that nobody will deceive you. You will be deceived because you don't know Jesus. Amen. I'm not going to waste time. Just stretch forth your hand. Stretch forth your hand. It's an error after you have suffered on earth here. You also suffer in hell. It's an error. So open your hand. Open your hand. And say, Father, my dwelling on earth here will never be in vain. You see, the reason why most of you here, you are asking God for something, and the thing is not happening, because the number one assignment for your life is to know him. Is to know him. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe will not die, but have life. So until you believe, don't expect life. So open your hand. And talk to him. My dwelling on earth here will never be a vain. Can never be a vain. Can never be a vain. If you have not known Christ, this is an opportunity for you to know him. For you to know him. It's an opportunity. It's an opportunity for you to know him. Some of you here, you don't really know him. How can a man of God? We come to the church of God. You came all the way from your home to the mountain just to pray for a politician who want to win an election. And the politician you are even praying for, maybe is in somewhere in Juju House. In Juju House. Looking for power to win an election. You as a man of God, you leave the prayer. The prayer and encounter you're supposed to have with Christ, and you are busy and wasting your time praying for a useless politician. See, where God is angry for many of us here. Angry for many of us here. Some people who have sacrificed human beings, they will come, they will carry money to you. They will need time, you will pray for them. No wonder after praying for them, begin to have problem with your life. Despite the money you are suffering. You are eating sour food. Sour food. Sour food. No wonder problem is coming around. You begin to wonder, God, I'm serving you. Why all this problem? Because you are eating sour food. So you have not heard that is a man will please the Lord. He will make his enemies to be at peace with him. You are running from your enemy. When you are supposed to obey the first assignment, the primary assignment, obedience. Isaiah 1:19, ye will eat the good of the land if ye are willing and obedient. You think one enemy can pursue you when you obey him? I have nothing else to do to you now, please. If you need Christ in your life, please come to the altar. I don't want to waste time with this. You need Christ in your life. Please come to the altar. You need Jesus in your life. Come to the altar. Have you been to Jesus with the feet and blood? Are you washed up the lamp? As your comment, as your garment, spotless are the white as snow. Are you washed? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed?
Are you washed
with the blood?
In
your garments.
As your garments, for there are no white as snow. I wash in the blood of the Lamb.
Please.
Immediately we share the grace. If you have not baptized, let me know. You have not baptized, let me know. Please stretch your hands upon them. Pray for them, for their soul. Pray for their soul. Pray for their soul. Pray for their soul. Kalimako Shatapalata.
In Jesus' name we pray.
God of Araya, I bring this one to the throne of their grace. And I pray, whatsoever challenges over their life and soul, make them to deviate from your way. Show mercy in the name of Jesus. I erase your name from the book of death and I write your name in the book of life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Today you are victorious. Death have no power over you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please go back. After the service, see me. God bless you. Go back. Stretch your hands. Just one prayer. I want to pray for you. Stretch your hands. In the name of Jesus, shout the amen very loud. May you have victory over Satan. You don't hear me. I say, may you have victory over Satan. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Clap your hands for Jesus.